Before there was a league, there was a tournament. Before there was Skyview Stadium, there was Benny Ballpark. This is the story of Wiff Or Be Wiffed, and it started with the Benevento brothers.
So it all started with me and my brother have always been doing stupid games in the yard, like that we'll play for 2 or 3 days and then they'll just kind of fade away. But wiffle ball was something that stuck. We'd play until, I don't know, 7, 8:30 at night and it'd get dark. And me and Alex were like, all right, how can we keep playing? We need to put up some lights. And then we had this hose, was our center field fence, and we were like, this is janky, so we bought a fence. And that's just kind of how the field progressed, and it just kept looking better and better. We bought a backstop, we got a mound, we got all these things that just kept making the field look better. From there, it just kind of took off. We were like, this is something that we really want to continue to do.
Benny Ballpark, I mean, a lot of memories there. That creativity was fostered in Benny Ballpark, and I think you don't have the modern day Skyview Stadium without Benny Ballpark, without us testing everything there, and without us bringing what we learned from that field to Skyview Stadium. And I think that's why it's such an important piece of history in our league.
Benny Ballpark was kind of cool for an amateur wiffle ball field. Good atmosphere, exciting, nice viewpoints. Players weren't that great.
I remember getting the invite for the 2015 Benny Ballpark. Really couldn't get enough of wiffle ball at the time, and I'd seen just people who have made this wiffle ball thing into a league, and I wanted to do just that. And so I reached out to Matt, asked him if he'd be interested in doing that.
Me and Alex went to our parents together, and we were like, can we start a league in our backyard? And my parents shut it down instantly.
Well, you guys were tearing up my lawn. I didn't want all that shit underneath my porch. You promised there'd be a lot of girls there watching, and there were none. So I shut it down.
But a Wiff Or Be Wiffed wouldn't be stopped that easily. Maddox had other plans.
So Maddox came to me with this idea about having a bunch of people over to play wiffle ball, baseball, softball, I don't know. I wasn't really listening. Next thing you know, there's a bunch of people in our yard.
I don't think they knew what they were getting themselves into.
Build day is something that's really special to me. It's arguably better than all of the wiffle ball itself in my eyes. Just seeing a project come together and working with my buddies to make that thing come together. And build day is just all of that put into one. Going to Home Depot and putting together something that's truly magical, it almost brings a tear to my eye.
I remember my first Home Depot run. They were looking for galvanized sheet metal for the strike zone. And they would just hit things to see if it made the right sound. They've used it ever since.
2020, before the fall season with that blue fence. That was the best this field has ever looked and probably will ever look. Tempered hardboard wasn't the best option. The fence would fall down and Maddox would hate everyone.
I fucking hate the blue fence. It set us back $200 and it was a pain in my ass for about 2 months. That and the tiki fence were really just a dynamic duo of a disgrace to this league. But with Matt's expertise and Home Depot and all that stuff, we were able to get past it.
Seeing this field evolve over the last 6 years has been one of the greatest joys of my life. We've really put a lot of hard work into it, and I think it always paid off because the field was always just looking so good. 2022, we actually won the CT Wiff Review Field of the Year Award. That's when things really came full circle, and we got recognized for all our hard work. That was a cool moment.
The first overall pick in the 2017 Wiff Or Be Wiffed draft. Marines Wiff Ball selects Matthew James Balkin, freshman.
So I was on the clock with the second pick, and Cleet's name was shining. It was just right in front of me. I had to take him.
I felt like I drafted a great team. I was expecting to honestly have a worse team coming out of the draft. I was thrilled that Alex fell to 3, and I thought he was going to go first overall.
So I had back-to-back picks, and the best player by far on the board was Henry Cannon, in my opinion. He was a good baseball player. I thought it would translate to wiffle ball, and it did somewhat. My next pick was Chris, which was another good pick right off after that.
With the rosters finalized, the boys set out to make their dreams a reality.
How do I characterize the season? Roller coaster, to say the least. A lot of ups and downs. It was never an issue of could we put up enough runs to kind of get it across. It was always an issue of can we hit the strike zone enough. Through the first 4 games, that didn't happen. Started on a losing streak, definitely.
Everyone was still coming into their own and trying to figure out just how good we could be.
I never lost faith in the guys, and you know, we turned it around, rattled off 3 straight wins in the regular season and carried that momentum into the postseason.
No, we started something special. It kicked everything off and it was a hell of a ride.
Maddox is ultra positive, as I would say, and he is really what pushed that team to a championship. The combination of me and Reed's fierce competitiveness along with Maddox's ability to bring people together, and I think that's what really characterizes Army.
That first year was something special.
In year two, after our championship, a bit of a falling out between myself and Reed Brown. We got into it a little bit.
I think the one thing I would say is it was disappointing. It hurt me after the fact that I let myself get to that point.
You know, Reed ended up basically quitting the league for the year and would come back the next year with Coast Guard.
It happened, and I think that we tried to move past it.
Army year two was one of the more interesting teams in league history. That lack of a first baseman really didn't affect us, especially because a majority of my outs would come from strikeouts. And Maddox definitely struggled a little bit on the mound at times. If we could get through the first inning, then we'd have the game and we'd win. And I think that's what led to our overall success and what led us to win another championship.
Year three of the league was 2020. The league was definitely very competitive. And from a commissioner standpoint, it was something I was very happy about. And we kind of just thought that we would just run it back for a third time and that we were kind of untouchable. We just got thumped by Air Force. They beat us in a clean sweep 2-0. After that year, I think a lot of things changed. What I wanted to do was create my own team and give Alex captainship. It was a move made as a commissioner, and it was something to balance the league out.
Joining the program, I thought Alex would still maintain his leadership position.
I wasn't going to be able to give the time and effort that I wanted to and that I felt was right with a captain.
Right away, he said, I think you deserve this. You have 1 year in the league. You have 7 ERA, 0 hits, 0 home runs. I think you should be the captain of the best program in wiffle ball history. And I said, you know what? I'll take it.
A lot of things changed, and that was the end of the Army dynasty.
Was on the team, of course, from the start. Was with Matt and Henry, and just loved being on the team.
I thought we had a good squad coming together, and that showed through the beginning of the season. We got 3 wins right off the bat, and then we didn't win the rest of the season.
Unfortunately, Matt had to leave to go to Air Force, so taking over the roles for Navy was, I thought, my moment to shine, and hopefully was able to do that during that second season where Garrett and I tried to, you know, make our push in the playoffs. Unfortunately, it was unsuccessful. Following that season, everything kind of just went downhill. The team just wasn't really coming together. Trying to pick up talent like Ben Graham and some other players didn't work out. Really thought we were going to be a whole new beast that year. Didn't turn out to be the case.
It was my first team, so it's always going to have a special place in my heart. To say we struggled was sort of an understatement. I mean, kind of fucking blue chunked.
Navy was a bit of a project at first. Came in to a winless program. Pretty brutal, not going to lie. So first thought was, you know, let's get out of here.
And Navy, I can't deal with those fucking bastards. Fuck them.
There was definitely a low point in our season, especially for me personally. We were going up Coast Guard, and he's now, of course, a beloved teammate of mine. We always thought Ian was sort of an easy out, but he had a very historic walk-off, and I hate to say I was the one who was pitching to him.
I understand it wasn't, like, the craziest of plays from an actual wobble perspective, but I appreciated how the whole league was kind of, like, rooting for me in a way.
Up until that walk-off, I knew Navy was kind of on the downhill. We couldn't compete with the rest of the teams. Once he had that walk-off, you saw at the end of that video, everyone's head was down. We kind of knew that was the end of Navy.
New virus.
Coronavirus.
Coronavirus.
I have today declared that the coronavirus presents a public health emergency in the United States.
Obviously, COVID wrecked a lot of things, but the fact that it got back on track in late May, you know, I think that's a testament to Mr. and Mrs. Underwood for just, you know, letting him do that. But also, Maddox just never quit on the league. And we needed that. It was a boring time. We were locked in our homes.
Not to make a pun out of a dark situation, but we had a really positive experience during COVID.
Wabwa was the only real, you know, routine social interaction that anybody had.
escape what was happening in the world and just the chaos that it felt like. And wiffle ball just kind of brought us all together.
Yeah. Can you feel it? I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience. Okay, just getting better each day. Stacking that to the cheesecake. Look up to the Lord we pray. Trying to be my best each day. Until I'm late, the rest of we late. To the time being we lit, hoping I don't let it get all in my head. I don't need the money just to say that I'm rich. Couple little honeys when they get in my bed. But they used to run for me when I had nothing. Now they wanna fuck cause they see me stunting. Nigga came up off the hustling, living in the lab of lux and I'm feeling like the man. If you ain't on my chucks then you wouldn't understand. On me, buy these rubber bands on me, make her wanna dance for me. Probably leave a man for me, standing in the stands, goddamn. She used to front way back, now she just a fan. Yeah. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. Now we on our way to greatness. And all I ever took was patience. I used to feel so devastated. At times I thought we'd never make it. But now we on our way to greatness. And all that ever took was patience.
I think that 2020 COVID season was one of our best ever. We had really high attendance and it was super competitive as a league.
Well, to me, it's all about loyalty, you know. I started with Marines, I'm gonna finish with Marines. I'm ride or die. It's really about community. I love hanging with the guys, drinking a cold beer, playing some wiffle ball, you know.
I was welcomed in. When I first came to the league, I was kind of lost, nervous, scared, but Matt, Brian, they welcomed me in.
Fell short year one for sure. I did not perform. Brian did not perform. Year two, things started to look a little better, a little more promising. But as Marines does, fell short in the playoffs.
We're just an inconsistent team. We can never really seem to get all of our starters there for the playoffs.
Start of the 2020 season, Maddox came to me about an expansion team.
It's really just heartbreaking having a brother betray you like that, but he wanted to be a star. He's just like Neymar. I mean, he'll never be as great as his brother, but he tried to be. We've had Teddy Cooney. He's been dialed. He seemed to found that slider and riser. He's really developed into a great pitcher.
He's been a great team. Brian brought me in like 2019-2020.
Regular season, we dominated.
We've had some great regular seasons. I believe we finished first place twice. I mean, that's pretty good.
Air Force entrances. Those were probably one of the highlights.
It's all about winning the game before it's even started. I mean, you show up in style, you intimidate your opponents. That's what it's all about.
Air Force entrances are unlike nothing else.
Kind of making wiffle ball as fun as we possibly could. So.
My name, calling all night. I can pull the wool while I'm being polite. Like, darling. Calling all night, I can be a fool while I'm being polite. Like, oh me, oh me, oh my. I know many women wanna be in my life. Like, oh me, oh me, oh my. Why can every woman end up being my wife? Even if she go away, even if she go away, even if she go away, even if she go away. I'm a classic man.
You know, that first championship against the Army, so many questions going back. Was it a team effort failure? Was it me? Was it Matt? You know, other people can be so quick to blame your co-cap, but you know, I'm never going to blame Matt for anything. He's a great guy, always been there for me. So I just think we fell short, and that's what it was.
Wasn't feeling like playing much more, you know. Didn't feel like I had an enemy, but I really love my guys, you know. Fly Falcons fly, if you will. So yeah, I just wanted to stay there, coach them up, you know, make those young little hatchlings into Falcons and watch them soar. And that's what we did that year.
Well, seriously, there came a point in my career where I was just like, all right, I got to buckle down and win this thing because things were getting serious. There had been two champions at that point. Losing in the championship really just kind of got to me, and I was like, we need to win this.
We wanted it since day one. We always talked about this.
We came out firing on all cylinders in 2020. It's one of the most fun years with COVID. We had nothing else on our minds but wiffle ball.
We were rocking and rolling. I mean, we had Matt going, Andrew. I was doing all right.
So the road through the playoffs in 2020 definitely wasn't an easy one for us. We started playing Army in that first round, which right off the bat, that's a tough game to win. They're a good program. They obviously won the last 2 years. I think we 2-0'd them. And then right after that, it was Coast Guard in the finals that we needed to take care of.
Third straight year going to the championship. I was ready to finally lift the trophy.
We weren't going to take them lightly.
Game one was rainy. It was a pitcher's duel, honestly. Balls were wet. People were slipping everywhere, but it was a great game. Matt and I both stepped up. And I mean, we finally won it all.
It was a really cool moment with me, Andrew, and Steven, all three of us hoisting it together because we'd played wiffle ball. All three of us had been in the league since the beginning, and none of us had won a championship.
It's so special, I can't even put it into words.
The guys couldn't get enough wiffle ball in the summer of 2020, so a fall league was created.
Fall league is, for lack of a better word, horseshit.
The championship that was supposed between Border Patrol and Air Force was canceled.
Things happen, meaning the commissioner shuts down the league. We had Border Patrol in the finals, who statistically is a really good team, but they didn't have the experience that a lot of us had. In my opinion, we probably could have won that championship pretty handily.
But it was really disappointing because the way Border Patrol and I looked at it was that we would have won first year in the league and a championship. Been pretty nice. Charles spent the whole next summer in Michigan. That summer is when Cleet went on his mission. So it was just me. And so Border Patrol had to be disbanded. I keep coming back because it's just so much fun. Coming out here, mostly Friday nights, hanging with the guys, playing some wiffle ball. You can't really beat it.
Now, things didn't always run smoothly for Wiff Or Be Wiffed.
Just got off school, trying to have some fun with the guys, play some wiffle ball. Nothing too rambunctious. Came back and our cars were keyed. You know, that was a dark day for me. And
it had to be the neighbors. Keyed all of our cars all in a row. On top of keying it, they decided to bang in my mirror.
My dad was pissed. I had to paint that first thing in the morning. Will not ever forget the fear in my soul when my car got keyed.
They did it again. And this time they just snapped my windshield wiper and threw it into the middle of the road.
So in 22, we hear some flashing lights through the Buchanan Police Department called on us. So they come to the backyard thinking they're about to bust a party. But just a bunch of dudes in pennies playing wiffle ball. And the cops, they're actually on our side. They were surprised as well.
Hey, the neighbors called the cops. They started a war with Wawa.
Fuck the neighbors.
Neighbors suck. Fuck the neighbors.
There were times where the weather was terrible, scheduling logistics, electrical problems. There would be circuit breaks in the house when we had eight lights going. And then on top of all that, I think one of the biggest ones was the bees on the wiffle ball field that stung a couple of our players.
Today comes another opportunity to take down the bees, equipped with two flying insect killer cans and a shovel to hopefully bury those motherfuckers.
One, expectations were definitely pretty low. The team was just kind of thrown together. I picked up Henry Cannon off of Coast Guard, Luke Bopp off of Marines, and then picked up rookie Joey Generales, who was being recruited by multiple teams. He turned out to be, you know, the real deal and was our number one option on the mound.
I had a sick riser. No one really kind of was figuring me out. And then I lost the zone. I was pretty bad for a while and didn't get rookie of the year. That kind of blew.
Our enemies, I think you can't throw a strike.
Space Force, we're a great organization. May not be in first place, but we're a sleeper team.
The spirit is here. Space Force is a winning team, and I know it.
We're explosive, always positive, never down on ourselves. We definitely struggled, but we never got down on ourselves. We always came back. We always fought. That's the one thing I love about this team.
I mean, so first year, obviously, didn't have a pitcher.
Team of all rookies, none of them really having high school baseball experience. Definitely a rough start. Started 0-6.
Well, I think we had a lot to prove. I think first year we obviously couldn't hit the fucking ball or anything like that. But at the end of the first year, Boz sort of figured out how to start pitching. And I think we got a little hot at the end of the year. That sort of made us hungry and want to come back and give another run. And then the finals, I think we got there and we were sort of pretty surprised at that point. But again, had to scrap it out. Had to a little bit of a, you know, sketchy game plan.
Scouts took the route of walking me every time and only pitching to Ian to get every single out of the entire game.
It worked out, had an unreal performance in Costco.
And obviously kudos to the scouts, you know, they were a young team, not much experience. They showed up in the league late and they made a lot of noise and ended up going all the way, which is, yeah, definitely impressive.
For all of us, probably highlights of our lives. There's nothing really better than that in life. It's just winning a championship of that caliber. And I think it'll be something that we all remember forever.
Nights at Skyview Stadium were always a good time, but some were more special than others.
Can you tell us about the old-timers game?
We talked about this. It's an exhibition and it was an all-star game. It was not an old-timers game. And if that's where we're going to start, we can just stop right now because that's bullshit. It was an all-star game. It was thought of because you guys were cute with what you were doing, but me and my brother have been playing wiffle ball from the time before you guys were even a wet dream. You know, we started playing wiffle ball back in Queens, back in Roxbury, New York.
Can you talk about the old-timers tradition?
Everybody knows that that's referred to properly as the all-star game, not the old-timers game. It was great tradition. We were victorious every time we won. People will say that's revisionist history, and they're absolutely wrong.
So we just thought, you know, the older generation, the seniors, the sages, if you will, of you guys and your development, it made sense that the name of the all-star competitors would be the Joint Chiefs.
The old-timers game was amazing. It was so much fun just to see my dad out there trying to take advantage of the youth that he still had left in him.
Getting competition against my son and his friends, great, great time.
It was super special being able to play wiffle ball with my dad. You taught me how to throw a ball. You taught me how to swing a bat. You taught me how to tie my shoes.
Gave us a chance to go back and relive our youth.
The best nights of the entire season. Mostly because winners win.
Maybe I instigated some trash talking. Maybe that happened a little bit, but at the end of it, it was just a great day.
It's a lot of fun. It's something I would have almost liked to have an old-timers league.
It's just really special being able to play with my dad because I know that he grew up playing wiffle ball and with my uncle as well and then with my own brother. I mean, this game has transcended generations and just like they were fooling around in the backyard, we're doing the same thing.
I know you're getting old, but you still look great. Love you, Dad.
So after Maddox came to me about being captain, I had to put together a team. Reed was first one I went to.
When Matt gave me the call, that I was ecstatic.
Put together a couple other members. We picked up Henry and Ian. 2020 season had a nice little run. I don't think anyone expected us to be as much of a powerhouse as we turned into.
Being able to play with a player of that caliber and his level of pitching and being able to 1-2 that was exciting.
A dynamic duo and a really good team. And I was kind of weighing them down. It was pretty spectacular what Reed and Matt were able to do together on the mound. To routinely win games in wiffle ball, and it's your defense that's winning you games, like that's probably another reason why nobody really liked Coast Guard when they were at their peak.
We also got a lot of hate.
And sometimes people gave us crap.
We really cannot stand those dudes. They like showboating, they like being assholes, to put it simply.
It's not like a short porch home run like Matt Balkan relied on for most of his career.
Bunch of fucking losers, to be honest with you guys.
We just love throwing to Coast Guard, especially Matt Balkan.
You got Ian, who's up there looking for a walk every at bat.
Beating Coast Guard, my least favorite team in the league.
I hate Coast Guard, dude. Hate them.
It was not subtle. Everybody just despised us every time we were playing. I think we fueled this hatred. We did not take kindly to everybody hating on us in the sand during the playoffs. And, you know, we came back 2021.
Took what could have been, and we made it a reality. We decided that we were going to be able to play at that level, and we did, and we backed it up.
It was obviously quite the jump going from Navy being like 2 and like whatever 20 to a championship winning team.
The team was able to bring that thing home, and you know, the celebration after was everything that I could hope for. And
we're definitive one seed all the way and just powered through, and it was great to be able to contribute.
It goes down in the record book as a championship ring right there.
Yeah, I felt pretty good. You know, that was like that, I think it peaked there.
But little did Ian know, Coast Guard was far from peaking. In July of 2023, they would find themselves against Space Force in the last ever Wobbwood Championship.
I'm a
might be too strung out on compliments, overdosed on confidence, started not to give a fuck and stop fearing the consequence, drinking every night because we drink to my accomplishments, faded way too long, I'm floating in and out of consciousness, and they saying I'm back, I'd agree with that, I just take my time with all this shit, I still believe in that, I had someone tell me I fell off, ooh I needed that, and they wanna see me pick back up, well where'd I leave it at, I know I exaggerated things, now I got it like that, tuck my napkin in my shirt cause I'm just mobbing like that, you don't put in well that you don't want a problem like that, you gon' make someone around me catch a body like that, no don't do it, please don't do it, cause one of us goes in and we all go through it, and Drizzy got the money, so Drizzy gon' pay it, those my brothers, I ain't even gotta say it, that's just something they know, they know.
Space Force in Extras, game one.
Jesus Christ. Space Force may have taken game one, but Coast Guard bounced back, setting up a winner-take-all game three. Wiff or Be Wiffed's final game.
Wob with Chip, you just had a perfect game for Coast Guard. How do you feel? Game three.
Feel amazing, but job's not done.
It's sentimental for sure. Definitely, you got some dogs on this team. It feels a little different.
I mean, I'm nervous, like anyone.
You know, I feel good. I think we're gonna come away with it. We just need to hit.
You're ready to win this.
It's definitely a bit emotional, but gotta come out with it. Gotta come out. It's the only thing on the mind.
Matt could end Wobble right here. And he does. Ladies and gentlemen, your 2023 Wiff or Be Wiffed champs. Coast Guard. The last ever Wobble champs. History.
I just can't believe it's over.
Your last ever Wiff or Be Wiffed champions, Coast Guard. That's a wrap, folks.
But like all good things, Wiff or Be Wiffed had to come to an end.
Basically, we've gotten to a point where the league is no longer sustainable. We have members moving across the country to North Carolina, Idaho, all over the place, guys on Mormon missions. Scheduling's been a pain in the butt with internships and guys getting jobs and feel like I can no longer carry the league on anymore. And while, you know, it's hard to say goodbye, it's been an unbelievable ride.
You know, it's really cool to see how many people we've touched with this league over the years. I can't seem to leave my house without seeing people wearing Air Force hats, Navy shirts, you know, just supporting our league because we've grown so much. You mostly see Army fans around. Boy Scouts are a really young crowd because of their passionate play. It really attracts the young people. And then, you know, Border Patrol, you see a lot of those fans down in Texas on the border.
Yeah, it's definitely sad, but I feel like in the best way possible, Wobble has almost run its course.
We've had 7 great years of wiffle ball, and it would be foolish to end it with anything else but a celebration.
Do I look lonely? I see the shadows on my face. People have told me I don't look the same. Maybe I lost weight. I'm playing hooky with the best of the best. Put my heart on my chest so that you can see it too. I'm walking the long road, watching the sky fall. The lace in your dress tangles my neck. How do I live?
like my heart is going to burst. Alone at a table for two, and I just wanna be served. And when you think of me, am I the best you've ever had? Share one more drink with me, smile even though you're sad. I'm walking the long road, watching the sky fall. The lace in your dress tangles my neck. How do I live?
What does Wiff or Be Wiffed mean to you?
Oh boy. Easily one of the best parts of my childhood.
Abla is everything.
Great men playing great games.
I mean, how could you not be romantic about Wiff ball?
Like the highlight of my summer.
It was always a lot of fun.
When I'm at Wabla, I'm home.
It's a nice spot in my heart.
It's something special.
Fell in love with the game. Fell in love with Wabla as a league.
It's a community.
Time to get together with my friends.
Great group of guys doing some inspirational things.
Wabla is a way of life.
It's not just Wiff ball, it's a family.
Memories and friends that I'm forever grateful for.
Wiff or Be Wiffed has given me the opportunity to create something so much more than just Wiff ball.
Well, after 7 years, our story comes to an end. Yes, the fence comes down and the lights turn off, but the memories, they don't go with it.
Slices and cuts. I want so much to open your eyes, 'cause I need you to look into mine. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Get up, get out, get away from these liars, 'cause they don't get your soul or your fire. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me that you'll open your eyes. Tell me. This feels strange and untrue.
How you like that, camera? Huh? Life could be a dream. Life could be a dream. Do 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 shaboom. Life could be a dream. If I could take you up in paradise up above, if you would tell me I'm the only one that you love, life could be a dream. Sweetheart, hello, hello again. Shaboom, hello, boom, we'll meet again, boom. Ding dong, ding dong, a lang, a lang, a lang. Oh, 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 pip, a bib, a dib, a dib, a dib, a dib. Oh, life could be a dream. If only all my precious plans would come true, if you would let me spend my whole life loving you, life could be a dream, sweetheart.
Didn't really have anything going on Friday night. Wasn't going to anything crazy.
Loser.
Shut up.
About.
Fuck!
Just take the first part of it and then I.
And, we unfortunately fell short to Air Force that season. What?
Stop going out the frame! Oh, yeah. Why'd you lick?
Let me tell you something that you probably already know. One thing for certain, two things for sure. I'm blessed. Always gonna be blessed. I'm fresh. Always gonna be fresh. One finger, one pinky, one thumb, one love.
And I think that 2020 COVID season was the best season we ever had.
Mom!
No, you are the shot. There we go.
Good cut!